This 3D printer has an infinite build volume because it can print itself higher. It can print metals and plastics, but most importantly, it can print itself. Imagine it creating two copies of itself in 48 hours. After 2 weeks, one would have 2,000 printers. After a month, over 10 million.
This lets us do amazing things. Send one of those to Mars, and by the time any humans show up, the printers will have reproduced and built a luxury Mars base. Or, if you feel like it, replace the production capacity of China in just a couple of months.
Anyway, exponential numbers are fun and all, but assembling 10 times the printers Prusa has ever sold in just a month is hard. Especially on Mars.
If we want our wildest dreams to come true, we have to figure out how we can put a big box into a smaller box. I hope you can see where I'm going with this.
You see, I am making a printer that can create an exact copy of itself. And not just the plastic parts. The motion system, the motors, the electronics, all of it. I am making a printer that requires no assembly, no fuss. Print it and start printing with it. Yes, I am making a print-in-place printer. If it can replicate itself, then it can print anything. It will be a printer that will end the age of centralized mass production. Freed by the shackles of yesterday's production techniques, and with the help of AI, we will create unique items for all. Why is your iPhone the same size as everybody else's if your hands are not? Why does your coffee machine not add the right amount of sugar and milk by itself? Why would you download a car? If you can generate a unique one that fits your needs exactly. Ow. Well, the software isn't entirely there yet, but let's make sure this thing does what it's supposed to do.
If we want the printer to copy itself without progressively becoming smaller and smaller and smaller, we have to solve this problem, which I'm pretty sure is impossible. However, there's another way. Here, we have two completely identical boxes. Neither one fits in the other, but watch this. Huh, this could work.
This is the Infinizy. As the name implies, it has the ability to print infinitely high. It can do this all thanks to this new setup that moves all the components, motors, electronics, hotend, everything, from the printer base onto the gantry of the 3D printer. With this, the entire printer can climb onto its four legs, and when there are no more legs to climb, it can simply print them higher. It does this by having the Z-axis mechanism inside the build volume. Thereby, it is able to print onto its own legs and extend them while it's printing another part. So, this does the same thing as a treadmill printer? One that uses a rolling bed to print infinitely long objects? On first glance, you might think so, but you would be wrong.
You see, the reason this printer has an infinite Z-axis is not to be able to print swords or other big things, but rather to be able to print itself. The infinite build volume is merely a side effect of its main objective.
If you measure the height and the side of this printer, you will see it fits on the build plate. And when you measure the length, well, that's why it can grow. Let's use this simplified frame to easier understand how this works. When a printer starts copying itself, it's not big enough. So then it extends itself until it fits. Oh, and who said you have to print the printer the same size every time? If you make the first copy larger, and then the second one even larger, well, congrats! You have extended your build volume in all three axes, and now you can print a full-sized car at home. With this goal of self-reproduction, it should make sense why there's a lot of focus on making the majority of the parts printable, and to reduce the number of non-printed parts. But at the moment, the printer only needs four screws. These hold all of these parts in place. And because most of the parts are printed, it can be assembled from scratch in just 15 minutes.
Wait a second. What is this about? A majority of the parts are printed and quick assembly? What are we, savages? Does he want us to bang rocks together to make tools to assemble that thing too? What is this?
This is the key to our wildest dreams. And don't worry about printing metals and electronics. You'll see soon how to do that at home for less than 100 bucks.
Let me instead show you why this initial design is such a great base for a printer that can create a full-size copy of itself.
Actually,
it's not just able to print a full-sized copy of itself, but rather two at a time. This allows us to use the actual printers that are being printed as the Z-axis legs, and thereby save time on not having to print those separately. This idea was already implemented in the first version, but it was later removed to save time between iterations, of which there were many. Just like every other project that is going to be done by the end of the week. You know how it is. The most iteration-hungry part to develop were the Z-axis legs. You know, these things. These legs are simply made by cutting along the length of an internally threaded tube. Initially, the legs used the standard thread profile. But, under load, that profile creates axial and radial forces. Usually, this is not a problem, because radial forces cancel out. But with this design, the threads are only engaging on one quarter of the circumference. The radial forces push the legs away from the worm gear, thereby getting disengaged and causing the printer to fall.
No!
It keeps falling down on this side, and this belt fell off. Everything just dies.
A bracket was used as a quick fix. However, this does not allow us to do this. So, a proper solution is needed. If we look at the root problem, it's clear that the positive thread angle is the issue. By reducing this to a negative value, the threads will no longer push themselves away, but rather attract each other. And because we know that these threads are only going to be used in this application, we can even make them directional, and thereby easier to print. Look at how this screw is holding onto one of its legs with no additional help. This is exactly what we needed.
We are not done yet, but if you've made it this far into the video and you're thinking, this guy could be a valuable member to our team, then feel free to reach out via my social media or email. I'm always looking for new projects to work on.
This printer is printing onto the already existing legs, rather than just an arbitrary point on a build plate, as a normal printer usually would. Predictably, this causes some problems we otherwise wouldn't have. Are the limit switches not perfectly mounted? That's a problem. Are your cheap pre-cut frame rods cheaply pre-cut, thereby altering the distance between the ladders and offsetting the extension prints? That's a problem. Does Kura Slicer create travel paths through do-not-print zones, causing your printer to crash and forcing you to print each extension individually? That's a problem. Do you have 9 hours of video of troubleshooting and problem solving that you now have to somehow condense into an entertaining 30-second segment? The main challenge we are facing at the moment is determining the position of the printhead relative to the legs.
This is a very familiar problem what traditional machinists experience every day. And luckily for us, we can look at what they're doing and use the same type of touch tool they use to precisely determine the position of the tool head relative to the workpiece.
But is a $3,000 thing really the solution we need? Or should we rather just put a conical tip on the BL touch sensor that's already on this printer and use trigonometry to figure out the exact position?
I don't know, but maybe you do.
Creating a fully print-in-place 3D printer is not easy for one person. And that is where Project Quine comes in. At the moment, it consists of Sean, Alex, and me. And the three of us have been working on this idea for a small while now. We need your help. I'm not asking for money, even though we currently don't have funding, but rather I'm asking for your time and effort.
We are releasing all our work for free. And I hope that you, yes you dear viewer, will look at it and add to it.
The Infinizy is solely an instrument that can perform a few pieces. But once it's played together with an orchestra of ideas, it will become a masterpiece. Hence why I hope to see your ideas in the future of this project.
Engineers like you and me run on coffee.
So let's speed up the printer's development by improving our coffee making process. A subject I've already explored. So go check that out. In upcoming videos, I will show you how you can print metals and electronics at home. So don't forget to subscribe.
As you can tell, this is not this.
And the YouTube algorithm does not take kindly to hour-long technical breakdowns. So I will upload an in-depth technical review for my Patreons.
Thanks for watching. I'm Sunshine. Bye.